Welcome to another episode of Qt Widgets and More. In the previous episode, I showed you a complex model view proxy model stack. In this episode, I'll show you how you can visualize that proxy model stack much more easily than through browsing the code, namely using GammaRay. You might remember this user interface from the previous video where I showed a complex interaction between the model view framework and my own model at the very bottom of a complex proxy model stack. If you haven't watched that episode, right here, there will be a URL where you can go and watch that first. Okay, welcome back. So I started KDAB viewer this time with GammaRay. So let me show you the cool thing. I go here, I control shift click on this view, and as you can see, I get the red rectangle here. But behind it all in GammaRay, I have my application starting too. You can see my table here. That's the I actually clicked inside the Qt or the table views scroll areas viewport. So we have the table up here. Now, if I go over here and I search for model, you can see the model that the topmost view is looking at. And I can right click on that model and show in models. Just appreciate that for a fact. That was pretty cool. And what you actually see here is now the Q, the column filter controller, :, filter model. You might remember from the previous episode that is the model that we look at, or that Q table view, namely the KDAB table view, is looking down into. This model looks into a sort filter proxy model, that looks into a cancel filter proxy model, that looks into a date filter proxy model, which looks into the training model at the very bottom. And you will see a lot of blurred data here because I'm not going to give you all my trainings away. But what you can see, at least the numbers over here, we got more and more data the further I went down into the stack. So at the very top, there was only my trainings in 2020. But as we went up the stack, you saw more and more of these trainings. You can even see more details about each of those. So if I click here, that is over here, you can see the actual element and it did have a tooltip role, as you can see. But we could also have seen some of the other properties. It is pretty nifty to read each stage of a complex proxy model setup, both when you try and learn about somebody else's code, but also about your own code years down the road. I'm Jesper Pedersen. Oh, you didn't, yeah, you're right. You didn't see the employee ID role in there. You only saw the display role and whatever in the sidebar for each of the roles. Well, as a courtesy to you, my dear viewer, let me fix that problem. See, it wasn't that difficult. Just took me 20 seconds. And here we are, employee ID 291. And if I click up here, still see the employee ID being 291. And you will actually see that throughout the whole stack. So all that I needed was to implement one method. And let me just go back in non-time-lapsed version. I needed to implement this one method here in role names in my training model. And it simply inserts that this particular integer maps to this ID. One observation in this whole thing, the stack of proxy models that you saw in the tree in the GammaRay would be utterly useless if it had said Q-sort filter proxy model, Q-sort filter proxy model, Q-sort filter proxy model, Q-sort filter proxy model, trainings model. or even worse, Q abstract table model. It doesn't, because I added Q underscore objects in all of my model classes. And I can't urge you enough to add this Q underscore objects to all of your model classes. The price you pay is less than 100 byte for the whole invocation of the whole binary, not per instance. Definitely worthwhile to make it much easier to debug your model view. In a later episode, I will show you a tool called Clazy, and it actually has a facility for inserting these Q underscore objects in all of your Q object subclasses. But stay tuned for that. That's for another day. I'm Jesper Pedersen. Thank you for watching Qt Widgets and more. Remember, thumbs up.